So, okay, ping is pretty simple, but how do you think traceroute works? I'm not going to make this a quiz because it really is pretty tricky. The ability to trace out packet paths wasn't intentionally built into the internet protocols. Rather, a clever engineer named Van Jacobsen discovered that a safety feature that was made to prevent infinite loops made it possible to do traceroute as well. Here's the safety feature traceroute makes use of. Every packet has a time to live, or TTL field, which starts at some large number and is reduced by one each time that packet hits a router. As it moves through the network, each router reduces the TTL on the packet by one as it passes it on, all the way until it finally gets to its destination. This means that if routers are misconfigured so that packets flow around in an infinite loop, eventually the time to live on each packet will drop to zero and it will expire. This helps keep momentary loops from crashing large parts of the network with an overload of traffic. When a packet's TTL expires, the router that last received it sends a tiny error message back to the packet's original sender. That message says that the packet's TTL expired, and it gives the address of the router that saw that packet die. So, given that idea, now can you think of how traceroute might work? The TTL mechanism means that if a program sends a packet with TTL 0, it will be immediately killed and an error message will come back. If it sends a packet with TTL 1, it'll go one hop, land on the first router, get decremented to 0, killed, and an error will come back. Then with TTL 2, it'll go two hops to the destination before it gets killed. So sending packets to a destination with progressively increasing TTLs, starting at 1, the traceroute program gets an error message back from each router on the way to that destination. And it can use those error messages to reconstruct the path, which is just the list of those routers in order that a packet takes to get to that destination.